Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Spaghetti Casserole Supreme. That has a lot of stuff in it, so we're going to start over the stove and get our spaghetti going. I have water that is boiling in a fairly large pot, and I'm putting in 1 teaspoon of salt. I like to salt the water there. What I have is 1 pound of spaghetti, and you'll notice that I've got it in here. I've been working on it a little bit. I've taken portions of it out like this. And then I've broken it in half. And then each half gets broken in half. You want pieces of spaghetti in this casserole, so you could maybe take a fork and get a nice bite. I'm going to put it in my boiling water. And the water will probably stop boiling, but it will come back to a boil. Then I'll reduce the heat and let this cook until it's al dente. It should be a little bit chewy, but it will be done. Now over here, I want to start something else. I have a deep skillet, and into that deep skillet, I have put Italian sausage. This happens to be hot, and this is mild. I decided to mix them up. And we have about 2.5 pounds. You can see that I've already removed the casings and cut them into small pieces. I'm going to turn this on. I'm going to add some chopped onion and some garlic powder. Let's get the garlic powder out of the way. This is 1 tablespoon. And I'll just sprinkle that over the top. And then we have 1 medium onion. Which is chopped. I can hear this heating up a little bit, and all of these are going to cook together. My sausage mixture is doing well, and I'm just stirring it occasionally like this so it doesn't really tear up those little bundles of Italian sausage. And we'll just let it continue to cook. It's almost there. When there is no pink showing, then I will drain it. And we'll come back on that. Our spaghetti is done, so I've turned it off. It needs to be drained, so I have a setup at the sink. And I'm going to drain it through here. And we'll be dealing with that in just a minute. Our Italian sausage is done. And I want to show you that I lifted it out of the skillet and I put it in a bowl, and I drained off probably 1/2 cup of grease that came from there, and I have blotted this to get any additional grease out. And you can see that Italian sausage does have quite a bit of grease, but I'm trying to minimize that because we love the flavor, but we don't like the bad effects of the grease. So I'm putting this back into my deep skillet. You can see there's still a little of that sauce at the bottom. I can accept that much. This makes a huge casserole. So we put that back in, and to that we're going to add some Italian sauce, and this is 4 cheese sauce. And if you can't get that, you can use any type of marinara sauce. You can use homemade marinara sauce. I have a really great recipe in Betty's Kitchen that you can use. I'm just doing this for convenience because there's so many things that go in this casserole. This is just one minor element, and I don't want to take all day making it. But this is 1 pint or 16 ounces, and I have 1 pint here as well. So I'm just going to stir those together. And as I said, this variety is 4 cheese, but you could use a different variety if you like some other flavor better. But altogether, you need 1 quart. So we'll pour that in over our Italian sausage and stir it. And then I'll turn it until it comes to a simmer, and then let it simmer lightly for 30 minutes. While my Italian sausage mixture with the Italian sauce is beginning to simmer, that's a good time for me to continue on the other part of the recipe. We have our spaghetti that we just cooked and drained, and we're going to put it into a very large bowl. So let's just turn this up. It's pretty well drained. And there it goes into the bowl. And we're going to add to this 2 tablespoons of melted butter. Excuse me. 2 well-beaten eggs. 1/2 cup of grated Parmesan cheese. This is the cheese that I used and I just hand grated it. 1/2 cup. Now we want to toss this together and then we will just set it aside while we let our Italian sausage cook. Here's our cooked Italian sausage in Italian sauce. You can see what it looks like. I told you to let it simmer 30 minutes, but I changed my mind on that once I saw the sauce thickening up as much as it has, because this is going to be baked in the oven and we don't want it completely dried out. So I think 20 minutes would be a good time to cook that. It will not kill the recipe if you do it for 30 minutes, but I think it'll be better if you take care of it without having so much heat applied. Now here is our mixture that we did of the spaghetti along with the butter and eggs and Parmesan cheese. So I'm going to put this in the bottom of my casserole dish, and I've got a very large casserole dish. Just use anything that will hold it, or if you have to, use 2 dishes and do the same thing in duplicate for smaller amounts. But I'm putting all of the spaghetti, which is coated nicely, and it had been sitting for most of the 20 minutes that I was using to cook the Italian sausage. And you just want to spread it out on the bottom so that the whole casserole gets some of this. And then on top of this, we're going to put some cottage cheese. So I have 2 cups of cottage cheese here. So it's 16 ounces. And I want to just put some dollops of it along here, and then I'll spread it out. Here's our casserole so far. It's not hard to spread out the cottage cheese, and it's going to give a lot of flavor as it bakes in the oven. But we do have our Italian sausage with the Italian sauce. We want to spread that over this. And this is not the last ingredient, but it's the last ingredient that goes on before it goes in the oven. Here's our casserole with the Italian sausage and sauce evened out the best I can. And you can level it a little bit by shaking it right and left and back and forth. This goes to a 350-degree oven and bakes for 30 minutes, but I'll keep an eye on it. If I decide it needs to be short of that, I'll let you know. But my recipe says 30 minutes, so we're going for 350 degrees, 30 minutes, and then we'll add something and continue. This is our spaghetti casserole after 30 minutes at 350 degrees. And you can see that the little pieces of sausage are beginning to brown up. It's really very nice at this point, but it seems to be missing something, and that is a topping. The topping is mozzarella cheese, and it's a lot of it. I have 24 ounces here, and I will use as much or as little as I think is necessary when I start spreading it, but I expect that I'll use most of it. So just spread shredded mozzarella cheese over the top. So this goes back to the oven, the same 350 degree oven, for 10 minutes. And that should melt the cheese and get it to brown off on the top a little bit. Our spaghetti casserole supreme is done and out of the oven. And it does have a few steps, but none of them are hard. So it's really a very easy casserole to make, and it makes so much that it's something you might want to try. It is very tasty, but I am going to take a bite for you and give you my impression. So I'm just going to take a spatula and cut down a square of this and bring it out. Although you may just spoon it out if you'd like to, however you want to serve it. All the way to the bottom, and there's what we have. So that looks nice. And what I plan to serve it with is some Italian bread. This Italian bread has some olive oil and a little bit of grated Parmesan cheese. This has the same thing, only it has some spices, some Italian, dried Italian herbs. So here's my plate, along with my green tea, ready to drink. And I want to get a little of this, which will go through to the bottom and get some of every layer, and let you know what my impression is. Okay, big bite. Here we go. Hot. But it is so tasty. It was hot. I should have blown on it first, but I got past that piece of Italian sausage that was huge and hot. This is just a wonderful, quote, Italian meal. I'm not going to call it Italian because it isn't an all-day cooked sauce or anything like that. It's just from Betty's Kitchen. It's just a Kentucky-style version of something we think looks Italian. So if you like spaghetti, an Italian sauce, and Italian sausage, and mozzarella cheese, this might be the recipe for you. I love it.